Hello my dear friends, welcome back to another video on privacy and security. In this video, we are going to talk about the privacy and security features of Firefox versus other Chromium browsers. Firefox is a browser based on Gecko engine, and most of you will know that all these four browsers, Vivaldi, Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge and Brave, are Chromium based browsers. Chromium was developed by Google in 2008. So let's directly jump into the video. So let's open Firefox first and see what the data and where the data is going. So let's open it. Here I have completely analyzed the browsing traffic that was going through mozilla.com or from the Firefox when I have first started the browser. So as you can see, there's some telemetry, but all of these things are going to Mozilla only. Mostly these six things are there when you first start the browser and nothing else than that. And this is the get pocket also. This is also bought by Mozilla. So basically these settings that are going. So there is no such privacy issue in Mozilla. And also there are a ton of features that Mozilla offers for privacy and tweaks. Firefox also gives an offer to completely turn off all these things in the settings. Okay, so let's now analyze the second browser, that is the Microsoft Edge browser. When you first open it, what happens? It loads a ton of your content. Ton of content. Even if you turn off every content from here, like going to custom, off, content off, then also it is sending all the data to Microsoft and also to all the news sites and organizations that were sponsored. All the links that you have seen here were sponsored links by Microsoft. And when you click on them, Microsoft earns a revenue. So that is a really, really shady thing to do. So let's see, where is the data going? When I opened it, this is Skype.com. I have never used Skype, so I don't know why this is going to Skype.com. These are some Bitwardens. No, this is not an issue. MSN.com. This is Microsoft News. And public suffix. I don't know what is it. Again, Skype. So a ton of data is going to Microsoft. Bing also. Even I have changed the search engine, then also the data is going to Bing. Scorecard research. I have not even opened any single website onto the system, into the Edge browser, but scorecard research, the data is going. Scorecard research is a advertising company, an analysis company. So you have to be bounded by their privacy policy, not by Microsoft privacy policy. So the data is going to Akamai.net. It is a content delivery network, I think so. So ton of data is going to Taboola. It is an advertising network. ZioTap is an advertising network. So the Yahoo.com. I never use Yahoo. But the data is going to Yahoo.com. These all are trackers inside Microsoft Edge. So if you are using Microsoft Edge for your privacy, just stop doing that. And immediately change your browser to anyone that I will recommend in the last. Apple Media Services. I never use any Apple device nor any service by Apple. Your data is going to all of these things. Network error log reports are also sending. It is sending every single data that it can send to Microsoft and to all these other companies also. That's a concern. In Mozilla's case, all the data that was going is only to Mozilla and not any other company. And they also give an offer to turn it off. But in the case of Chromium, you cannot completely turn it off. So the ton of data is going here and there. Okay. Outbrain.com. All of these are trackers. So you know, Edge is not a privacy friendly browser at all. So let's see another browser. The next browser on our list is the Brave browser, which tell themselves as the best privacy browser at all of all times, and many of you are already using them. So let's see where their data is going. When I first open it, all the data is going to Google first of all. Why? Because they have a deal with Google for their default search engine. That's not a major issue. But what is this? The data is going to pub network. It is an advertising network, instant page. Second, though, I never open any page. They have also their own advertising networks, means Brave Rewards. So your data is also going to Brave Rewards. Even if it is anonymous, you have no right to analyze that it is anonymous because it is already encrypted. So you have to trust them also, and also why the data is going to these. So this makes Brave not a very good browser for the privacy. Although it gives some good features about fingerprinting protection, but it's not well enough than they say they are. So let's analyze another browser. It is a different browser than all these browsers. Mostly these browsers have open source, like Brave is also open source and Firefox is open source. This Microsoft Edge Chromium is a proprietary software. Vivaldi is also a proprietary software. First of all, it's not open source, but they claim that they have privacy built into their browser. So when I first opened Vivaldi browser, what happened at that point of time? The data is going to google.com because Google has been set as default search engine by default in my country. Vivaldi.com, no issue, but here the issue comes. I never opened any site through that, but the data is going to Amazon. I think all of these are affiliate links. Advertising Amazon, AWS Amazon. And not only them, Blink from home. All the random URLs, your data is going through all of them. And no general person knows that unless they analyze the network. And it's not very easy to analyze a network unless you install a pi-hole. I will make a different video on pi-hole. After some time, your data is going to Amazon, Blink for Home, Eero.com, Fabu.com, Goodreads, I don't know what they are, all of them. ShopBob, Vote, Zappers. So I never recommend, if you worry about your privacy, if privacy is your fundamental thing, so I never recommend to use Vivaldi browser because you don't know who these are. You only know Amazon, but who these are? Alexa, Amazon Jobs, Unagi. It is just all of this data is only based on the first open of the browser. It's not any other type of data. When you first open the browser, all of this data goes to all of their servers. Even you didn't click at all at any point. So as you can see, this is Google. But eStain.com, dpreview.com, comoxylogy.com. So I don't think you can trust Vivaldi for your privacy and security purposes. So let's analyze another browser. And the last on our list, that browser is the most famous at all, with mostly 65% market share around the world. And that is Google Chrome. So what about them? Most of the people think that that browser is the worst for privacy and that and this and that. But I don't think so. In my case, when I analyzed complete network for Google Chrome, what I saw is that the data is going to google.com because Google set as default search engine. To DuckDuckGo.com also at one point, but it's also not an issue. I didn't see any entry that was very, very suspicious in my respect. No data is going through any advertising domain other than Google. No data is going to Amazon.com or any other advertising network. So I think Google Chrome is a good browser for a privacy. You can completely count on them. So if I have to rank the browsers in terms of their privacy, so the best browser in terms of privacy is Mozilla Firefox. The second browser that I can recommend to you is Google Chrome. Google Chrome is also best for privacy, and ultimately the security of Google Chrome is the highest among all these browsers. The third browser on my list that I recommend to you for your privacy is basically Brave browser. Here it's Brave. Okay. You have to turn off every setting into the browser by yourself. You have to turn off Brave Rewards. And you have to change your default search engine from Google to any other service like Quant or DuckDuckGo. I will not recommend to you to use Edge Browser or Vivaldi Browser at all. You can use them after using many extensions like uBlock Origin, Privacy Badger, and blocking them by Pi-hole and so on and so forth. But that is so much of work for a general person to surfing the net. You can see the Vivaldi browser has so much data going on to these, and you cannot read all of these things privacy policies. You can only read Vivaldi privacy policy. No? That's why. Now let's check the security aspect of these browsers. This is a very good site to check the security of your own browser after doing your own configurations. I have not done any configuration. This is the default configuration of every browser that I am going to tell you. When I'm going to dashboard, this is Firefox. So let's see what happens here. So after the result, here they are saying the secure. So means the browser is secure. There is no high risk. There is no interception. There is no broken cryptography in the browser. There are some issues with moderate risk, but that's okay. That's not a dangerous condition at all. 2 here, domain security policies, 2 here, and 3 here. So basically, there are 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 basically vulnerabilities in the security, we can say. That is a very general test for this browser, okay? So let's go to any other Chromium browser and repeat the test again and again. So the second browser on our list is Microsoft Edge. We are testing the security. So let's go to dashboard and check. So it is also a secure browser. I can say you can count on this browser for your security, but not for your privacy purposes. Okay. Because it's based on Chromium, so it is more secure. So there are 2 vulnerabilities in this, moderate risk, 2 in this, and 3 in this. Basically, there are 7 vulnerabilities. It is as secure as Firefox, but very less privacy focused than Firefox. So I recommend Firefox against it every time. Let's go to Google Chrome and repeat the same test again. So here we have the Google Chrome browser in front of us. You can see it is also a very secure browser. So if you are not good with Firefox based browsers, you can use this browser and there is no issue at all. Just remember, do not sync at all, and it will be privacy friendly then. There are 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are also 7 vulnerabilities in this. Okay, let's go to our next browser. That is Vivaldi. Surprisingly, Vivaldi is the most secure of all the browsers that I have tested today. But it's not very private, so you can use it at your own risk basically. So there are just 5 vulnerabilities in this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So you can count on the security aspect of this browser. It is also based on Chromium, and its Chromium version is higher than Chrome right now. Its Chromium version is 90.0.4430.214. And Chrome's latest version at this point of time is 212. So that's why it's more secure than Chrome and other browsers. So I have tested the last browser, that is Brave browser, at this point of time with the default settings completely. And you can see there are 2, 2, and 3. Basically, there are also 7 vulnerabilities in this browser in terms of security aspect. So the most secure browser is Vivaldi. The most private browser is Firefox. And the browser that balances privacy and security the best is Google Chrome. And I do not recommend you to use Microsoft Edge at all. So that's all from my side. We'll see you in the next one. Subscribe to my channel for more of these videos coming every week.